It's Joanna McGrath. I saw an article on Facebook that was posted, and I read it, and I have been jumping up and down, blasting out texts across Facebook, trying to wake people up to recall Mary Ellen Elia. Well, I guess Mary Ellen Elia may face a no-confidence vote by the school board. And so what I did was, this is Hillsborough County's school board, okay? And what I've done is I've listed their picture, and then underneath I have put, look, their email address. And underneath that, if they have a Facebook page. So what I did was, Cindy Stewart had a Facebook page, and I've only done it on hers so far. So I'm going to make this video, and then if you will look at my Facebook posts that I put on her page, and go by and like them and reshare them if it would allow you to. But this is what I have done so far, and this is off of my website, corecougars.com. And if you have not had a chance to go and read the article by TBO.com, please, 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 please. But you know what? I'll tell you what. I don't have a stand to put my camera on. And, oh, they left it. I left a comment on the TBO, and they erased it. So then I went and I reposted it again. But look at this post right here, okay? Please read that post. I mean, it knocked my socks off. But so I don't get a copyright strike or anything, I'm going to read this article. Elia may face no confidence vote by school board. And this was posted on January 6th, so that was 2 days ago. And today is January 8th. And it reads, Tampa, in their first meeting of 2015, Hillsborough County School Board members expect to discuss whether they feel confident Superintendent Mary Ellen Elia should continue as the school district's leader. No board members reached Tuesday would publicly say who plans to bring up the issue or how they would vote on a motion of no confidence. But several said they anticipate Elia's job performance will come up as soon as their January 20th meeting. I'm open to having that conversation, said board member Cindy Stewart. If we're going to have a conversation, it needs to happen quick. The uncertainty is starting to trickle down to our sites. Well, it didn't trickle down to her side. I blasted it. Elia's leadership of the 8th largest school district in the country was an issue in the November school board election. And since then, people have attended board meetings to speak for and against her during public comment segments. The school district is Hillsborough County's largest employer of some 30,000 workers and 200,000 students. Did you hear that? 30,000 workers. 30,000 workers contributing to Common Core. Contributing to dumbing down our children. Did you ever think of that? I was reading the article and I was just like, wow. But anyway, so, and that's 200,000 students. The potential challenge comes as Elia, named by her peers as Florida superintendent of the last year, last month, is in the running as one of the four finalists for National Superintendent of the Year. Hillsborough's first female superintendent, Elia, joined the district as a teacher in 1986, is in her 10th year in the job. I'm going to go to the next page. On Tuesday, Elia said she had no knowledge of a possible no-confidence vote. Typically, the 7 school board member turns in their evaluations of Elia in the fall, then decide whether to extend her contract. In August, they collectively rated Elia above satisfactory. there was two deaths, two children's deaths on her watch. Sorry, because of cutbacks and stuff. I just read that from an article. I mean, you'd have to go research to prove it. But in the current challenge, some comes from Elia's past critics. It might be led by board member April Griffin and this year's chairwoman, Susan Valdez. They gave the superintendent the lowest evaluation of all the board members the last 2 years. Elia showed her support for Griffin's opponent in the November school board race by posting a candidate sign in the yard of her South Tampa home. So to me, that's a conflict of interest when you do that, because you're like trying to say, hey, I want her on board with me. But if she has issues, why would you bring that up, you know, Griffin's opponent on board to support Elia? I'm like, come on, what are we thinking here? Anyways, I'm glad she didn't get voted in. Griffin has called Elia's leadership style unyielding and said employee morale in the district is at an all-time low. I know this from a fact. When they were discussing the school bus issue, and the school buses are horrible. Any parent that allows their child to get on one of those old rickety old buses, holy cow, we were so blessed that our school bus driver will not drive that school bus if there's anything wrong with it. She refuses to drive it. And I'm just so thankful. And that's all I'm going to put out there. So, you know, that's one of the things. And even I couldn't believe when I had heard through one of the bus drivers that Miss Elia showed up, and the comment that was made that if they say anything derogatory on their Facebook pages or anything derogatory about Miss Elia, they can lose their job. Who the heck? I mean, are we living in communist China? I mean, come on, people. Who gives Miss Elia the right to go to the bus garage and tell people what they can and can't do on their off time? I would have told her to go pound hard, and I would have handed in my resignation. Nobody is going to tell me what I can and can't do on my off time. People need to get balls. Come on. If you remain silent, you are telling the government you agree with everything that they are doing. So keep on remaining silent. And there's a lady out there on YouTube called Kitty Werthmann. She was in Austria when Hitler came into regime. The country was a disaster. They were in a depression. He comes in with all these hopes of saving the country. And what happens? It turns into a communist country. She went into her classroom one day as she talks, and it was communism. Is that what we want here in the United States? Well, then you better start speaking up. I don't know exactly what's going to happen on the 20th, Griffin said. I do think it's a conversation the board needs to have. They don't need to have it. They need to recall her. Get her out of there. She is pro-Common Core. And if you don't believe me, I'm going to show you some links. I'll go back on all those links I posted on that Facebook site and show you what I'm talking about. And grow some gonads. And you get out there on that board and you get out on those scores and you tell those school board representatives that they work for us. Get her out of there. Sorry, got a little excited. Board attorney Jim Porter said a vote of no confidence in the superintendent would serve only as a symbolic message to her. Symbolic my ass. Recall her. It wouldn't have any legal impact at all, he said. Oh, well, look at her violating the Constitution, the Common Core. Do you know Common Core is illegal? I'll show that to you, too. Removing her from her $283,000 a year post requires buying her out of her contract. Buy her out my ass. Fire. Or firing her for cause. Yeah, violating the Constitution. There you go. Crimes against humanity. Child abuse. Porter said, Elia has 2.5 years left on a 3-year contract. Board member Dorissa Edgecombe said she hasn't thought about how she would vote. How y'all would vote? Let me tell you something. Everybody, all y'all, sitting on that Hillsborough County School Board, you are violating the Constitution when you allow them to implement Common Core here in Hillsborough County. You are in violation of the Constitution, child abuse, crimes against humanity, with all that testing crap going on. Do you know my child went through 3 weeks of test prepping, scaring the daylights out of her so she wouldn't cheat on her test? What are we doing to our children? Y'all need to wake up! The superintendent has done a fine job, she said. Yeah, fine job? How many kids were killed on her watch? Is that a fine job? Child abuse. Is that a fine job? Crimes against humanity. Is that a fine job? Violating the Constitution of the United States. Is that a fine job? Both of the board's new members, Melissa Snively and Sally Harris, say they aren't sure yet of how they would vote. Well, you better think about it, because people are waking up. We all, as we the people, should get a sheriff, because they hold the most powerful position. Do you know the sheriff is the most powerful position? He can go to the White House and arrest the President of the United States. Well, if he can do that, then we can go down to our school board and have them all arrested. Snively read about the possibility of a no-confidence vote in La Gaceta, a local weekly newspaper. I'm going to have to do some serious consideration over the next couple of weeks, she said. Harris said she was flabbergasted to hear about a potential no-confidence vote, but added that the one meeting she had with the superintendent was a positive one. She said to me, I hope you are on board on a new... Let's see, I know you are a new board member. Elia said this? I'm like, if I'm reading this correctly, that would say, Elia said to me, I know you are a new board member, and if I can help you clear anything up, I'm here, Harris said. She really reached out to me. Well, hell yeah, she's reaching out to you. Put your face in front of a TV. It's called TV programming. You're sitting in front of a TV, and it's programming you. Like when you go to school for institutional instruction and you got those teachers that are coming in. You know, even these, I don't want to say names, but I'm going to tell you something. You got seasoned teachers that know that Common Core is wrong. But yet they're doing it anyways. You got these new teachers coming in and they're teaching them the Common Core and they think that that's what they're supposed to be teaching these kids. And that is not what they're supposed to be teaching those kids. You need to wake up. Are you part of the problem or are you part of the solution? All right. So on that article that was posted on Cindy Stewart's Facebook page, that's where I found it, here besides other places on the Facebook. But let me show you something. Let's see, I put Cindy Stewart for Hillsborough County School Board. Have you seen this research done on Mary Ellen Elia? Well, let's go look at that. Let's click that link. And let me go show you the research I did on Mary Ellen Elia. You know, go listen to these videos. It's not going to hurt you to listen to them, but check this out. She founded the first charter school. It was Lee. Now, we're going to go through here and look. Mary Ellen Elia, Hillsborough County Board Leasing Corporation. You see that? Hillsborough School Board Leasing Corporation. Look, Mary Ellen Elia. Look at this. You see this? Look at that. You see that? Look at all these. I mean, go through these and click these links. You just click on them and they pop bigger. Let me see if I can get this one to do it. Yeah, see? Look, see? Mary Ellen Elia. Look at that. Look at that. Let's see. Looky here. Specialized, see, Magnet Schools of America. Specialized Director, Mary Ellen Elia. and look at what dates, 2002 to 2004. Go read this stuff. Look, Magnet Schools of America. All right? It's inactive now, but anyways, look here. Let's do these real quick. I just want to show you. Look. Look at that. See that? Mary Ellen Elia. Title. See? President. Look at it. Trying to find some key information so I can point these out. I forgot why I posted all this, but that was just to show the Magnet Schools of America. But here it is. Look at that. Human capital. See that? That's from the Magnet Schools of America. Your children are human capital. You see that? That's what Mary Ellen Elia thinks of your children as human capital. This shows that it's a business. Go look at it. Fundraiser. Look at the, I don't know if it's going to show this, but you're going to have to go out there, but look at the companies, the names on this. Look, the board of directors. All right, let's see. Look at here. There she is. Mary Ellen Elia. See that? Okay. MSA. Board of Directors. I forgot what MSA. Magnet Schools of America. MSA. Okay. Here's their annual report. You can click on that. Go look at that. Oh, well, there you go. So you can just click on them and check it out. I'm not going to go through it right now because I want to get through this. But look. Reformer. See that? Foundation for Excellence in Education. Reformer. And look who the reformer is. Look at that. See that? Well, what do you say? Well, what's the big deal? Well, look, it's a business. See? It's a business. Look, go read all them documents that are out there. Look, you know, meet our donors. Look at this. You recognize that name under Foundation for Excellence in Education? Are you putting two and two together yet? Wait till you see the flow charts. Look at this, the Walton family. Do you know who the Walton family is? Walmart. You shop at Walmart? Me too. But anyway, so I digress. Go read this stuff. I put it out there. You know, thinking people would get it. There's one more thing I wanted to show you. But look at the contributors. Look how much money they're contributing. Look at the model legislation. Look. Oh, my goodness. Oh, here we go. You ready? Foundation for Excellence in Education. This is a muckety map, okay? And when you go out there and you click on this map, it should take you over there to muckety. And the ones with the solid lines are the current, and the ones with the dotted lines are past. But look at this. That is a solid line too. See that? And who else is part of the Excellence Foundation for Excellence in Education? Mary Ellen Elia. Look, Walton family. Look at these names and go out there and do your research. And then you want to know why should she be recalled? Why Mary Ellen Elia should be fired? Look, Foundation for Excellence in Education. She's there. I can't find her right now, but, you know, she's there. Go look at it. Look, see? Look, who is that person? Oh, well, look, Common Core Standards, Florida Standards, Foundation for Excellence in Education. Are you getting the connection yet? Look at that. Chairman's letter. Foundation for Excellence in Education. Oh, and then we have Impatient Optimists. Look at that. Do you see that? Who is that? Who is that? Look at this. All right, well, I'm going to get out of this. I want to go back over here. All right, now, look here. Did you know this about Common Core? So let's click on that and see what this is. What can you do? Well, let's looky here. Common Core, aka Florida Standards, is illegal. Anyone supporting it, anyone implementing it, is breaking the law. Common Core violates 3 federal laws, 10th Amendment, Florida Constitution. Core, aka Common Core, is crimes against humanity, child abuse, data mining. It is a business. Send this to your legislators, school boards, teachers, schools, and teachers. Who should be going to jail? Look, this is Senator Alan Hayes. You go listen to this video and tell me you are still for Common Core. Look at all this. Look at all the information. Look at this gentleman here. He's a lieutenant colonel. And he is trying to wake people up to Common Core. Look at this. These on this side right here, I went and I pulled all the information on the statutes, on everything that I could find, what it violates on Common Core. Okay, you keep going down. Then here on the right side, look at this. This is the agenda to Common Core. All right, look at this. Go all the way down, okay? Educare. They want your kids for 16 hours a day, Arnie Duncan does. Okay, keep going down all this. Look, it violates the Florida Constitution. Keep going on down. Look here, you go watch this video and tell me if it don't bring tears to your eyes. If it doesn't, you ain't human. Look at crimes against humanity. Look, somebody even wrote a book on it. See this lady here? Oh my gosh, she obliterated the school board. And she wrote a book. You want to read something? Go get that book. And all these links, click on them, and it takes you over here. Listen to this student about the test taking. Oh, I was floored. Keep going on. Oh, look at this one. You like that? Go. This is all Arnie Duncan. Go read all that. This is what he has planned for your children. Look, the data mining. Look at here. Look at all the data mining. You go listen to this video on the data mining. All right, keep going. Go look through it all. Go here, Title 20, Education. Go read that and see if you are not like, anyway. So, I just get so worked up over this. It's amazing that people don't see this. And look, you know, here, Common Core is a business. You know, look at this. Look at this. Look, you know, I've been trying to put this video out for some time now, but I get so hot under the collar, I cannot get it out. But I listed as much information on her as I can, along with Lynn. That's Lynn Shear. Where's she at? Let's see. Here she goes. Dr. Allison Ramprasad. Oh my gosh, I posted her letter to the school board. But look at this. Go out there and look. Look, it is a business. You see this? Look, you can go click on this and go look at the report. Look. All right? You want to keep going? Look, there is a positive solution. You can watch all Charlotte Iserbate's videos. She has a positive solution to all this. So does Samuel L. Blumenfeld. He has a proven curriculum that will help our children excel. John Taylor Gatto, he has a proven system to help our children excel. Come on, people, wake up. Look at this. Look! American Public Education. Look at this. It's a business. See? In your face. Common Core educational standards. In your face. Look at that. Look at the money. Common Core education needs to be abolished. You see all the money? Walton family, Walmart, Jeb Bush. I mean, go look at all of this. Florida State Board of Education. Go look at these. And these are my maps. But go look at them. And I did it all through Muckety. You can click on the map. Oh, you want to get even a little bit deeper into it? The Charter School Funding Network. You know that school choice? You still liking that school choice now? Look. Look at this. United States Department of Education. The D little O E D, also referred to as the ED. Wait, it gets better. Education. Many in the Republican Party who saw the department as unconstitutional, arguing that the Constitution doesn't mention education and deemed it an unnecessary and illegal federal bureaucratic intrusion into local affairs. The American Federation of Teachers opposed it. You think them teachers know something? The primary function of the Department of Education are to establish policy for, administer, and coordinate most federal assistance to education, collect data on U.S. schools, and to enforce federal educational laws requiring privacy and civil rights. The Department of Education does not establish schools or colleges. The Office of the Inspector General conducts audits and investigations into connection to the department's programs. Education in the United States is highly decentralized. The federal government and Department of Education are not heavily involved in determining curricula, bullcrap, or educational standards, with the recent exception of the No Child Left Behind. You see that? You know what that means? No child. No child will be left behind. I don't care if you homeschool, public school, private school, charter school, IB school. No child will be left behind. Remember the era of Hitler and how he just scarfed up all those kids? You guys better wake up. This has been left to state and local school districts. Has it really? Has it? The quality of education institutions and their degrees is maintained through an informed private process known as accreditation, over which the Department of Education has no direct public jurisdictional control. The department's mission is to promote student achievement and preparation for global competitiveness by fostering educational excellence and ensuring equal access. Let me show y'all something. That race to the top? Yeah, yeah, yeah. Go on, go read it all. Look at here. See this right here? Look at that. We the people of Hillsborough County, time to recall Mary Ellen Ilya. Well, I didn't get far that far to finish, but. Oh, let's see. We got through that one. Let's go down here to this one. All right. Let's go here. Common Core standards are developmentally appropriate. Are they really? They're developmentally not appropriate. You want to listen to someone? Go listen to Danita Brown. She did this fabulous PowerPoint presentation, which I copied and pasted on the side here. You go look at this. You see this gentleman right here? There's some information there you should look at. Go look at all this information. I'm not going to get into it because it's like getting really long. So I'm going to kind of cut it short here. There's the other one. Developmentally appropriate. Let's see. All right. Go listen to these professionals. She has a PhD. See that? Okay, and then I put here, is there a solution? Yes. And I put recall Mary Ellen Elia. And look here, you want to talk about something? Here's Charlotte Iserbein. Oops, this is her Facebook page. I want the page I put together. Here, look at here. Go listen to this information that has been put together by her. And I just put it all in one location. But go listen to all her videos. You will be floored. She worked under the Reagan administration. She was an advisor, senior policy advisor in the U.S. Department of Education. Let's see. Okay, and then I want you to please go look at Samuel L. Blumenfeld's stuff. You know, because of Alpha Phonics, my daughter is not going to be classified with dyslexia because he helped me turn her around because they have removed the alphabet code from the English language. And then they want to wonder why kids are so stupid and why they hate reading. I started off with this book here. Look at his books. You want to talk about the National Education Association? Go read that book. Oh, I had to take it in bites. I kept putting it down. But look, he. Just go listen. If you don't listen to any of his stuff, go listen to this video. Okay? All right. And then there's John Taylor Gatto. And his is. Let's see. John Taylor Gatto. He has, I think it's like a 4 or 5, 6 hour video, but it is well worth the time. Go listen to him. And then I'll just end it off with my site here, because this has gotten way too long. But this is my site here. As soon as it comes up, or it's not, oh well. Here, let me show you. Let me get there. It's Core, Core, cougars.com. Okay, this is my site. Just go through. Look, listen to Karen. And this is her book. Just listen to her. Listen to these people. Senator Alan Hayes, please just listen to these people. Go through the website. Alison Rampersad, go listen to her. You know, you guys, I'm beyond words. So if you want to know if Mary Ellen Elia should be removed, she needs to be fired. And I showed you why. And I've given you all the reasons why. Go listen to this. Look, here's our Constitution on video. Go listen to it. There it is. It's printed. You can like print it off. Oh my goodness. So much information. Here's a Facebook group. There's another. Gosh, you know, Kathleen Jasper, she was a teacher and she's speaking up and she's trying to. Look, you want to talk about data mining? Go follow him out on Twitter. Contact him. He'll give you an earful. Oh, here's another wonderful lady. She's out on Facebook. Go go connect with these people. Look, you can click on each one of these, or it's in a little PDF format by clicking there. Listen to the Dumbing Down of America videos. Look, here's another one. There's more. You know, look at the flow charts of the money. They are all in bed together. You want to know about Common Core? Go look. They're all clickable links. Oh, go listen to Miss Sullivan. She'll break your heart. Oh, look, Common Core, proving it is a business. Go look, here's a student. You know, is anybody listening? Please, please, please. I am going to. Oh, gosh. Listen to this. Listen. Oh, man. Josie Outlaw, boy. Woo! She just puts it like it is, you know. So I am going to end my video here. And I just want to say, if you've gotten this far, thank you for listening. And it's all a lot of important information. And oh, here's a book called The Brainy Bunch. You know, this mom homeschools. And. But. Did you know that we homeschooled before we sent our kids to institutional instruction? Brainwashing. I'm exhausted. I'm without words. Wake up. Go do your research. Contact your school board. I gave you the information. It's under Cork, C-O-R-K. Cork Cougars, so it's Cork Cougars and Core Cougars. But, you know, I updated the information out there on the school board. And there they are. And there's their emails. Get out there. We need someone pro-children, pro-education. We need your help saving the children. Because if we don't do it, who's going to do it? Is the government doing a really good job educating those children? Do you realize if they align the tests, the assessments, with the curriculum, we have no say? And if you think that just because you're homeschooling your kids, go out there and look on that FPEA site, FPEA, and get the convention pamphlet from 2014 and look at all the Common Core in there. If you think you're private schooling your children, you think you're going to save them. Common Core, the No Child Left Behind. They're telling you something right there in your face. No child left behind. Do you get it now? I'm out. Go contact them school board members and tell you how you feel. Send them this video. Like this video. Don't like this video. Spread this video around. But get the information out there. If you think you can't do nothing just by commenting or passing this video around, you are doing something. And you may be waking up somebody else. Remember, keep on remaining silent, because all you're doing is telling the government you approve of what they're doing. So if you don't approve with what they're doing, you need to speak up and you need to say something. Go tell these school board members. She's fired. She's out of here. Or change your ways. And you start taking an interest in our children, Miss Mary Ellen Ely, if you're watching this video. Because you do not have our children's best interest at heart. How much are you getting paid? How much money is going in your pocket? Is it more about the money than our children? Is there going to be a U-Haul behind your casket? When you decide one day you're going to cross over, if this does not hit you and wake you up, I don't know what will. Our children are not for sale. Come on. If all the information I have showed and you are watching this, Mary Ellen Ilya, please let it sink in and wake up and start going to bat for our children. If not, it's time you be recalled. And if the school board members are watching this and you're not doing nothing about it, you need to be fired. I'm out.